What's up everyone, welcome to part 27 of developing Android application for your Android mobile phone. So as you know that when we start making Android application, you have to get used to it. You need to have to be addicted to create more and more applications. So that is going to make yourself much more addicted to Android Studio, and you can create more and more application, and that is going to make your life much more easier. So we are going to make a small application that is going to be named as Ludo Dice. So we are going to create two dice for that, and let's get started with creating some application for that. So for that I have to keep capital L, because that was keeping me the error that I have to keep LU. So there is a warning on that, that first letter should be L capital. So L Ludo D-I-C-E dice. So Ludo dice, Nazir is my name.com. Click on next, Jelly Bean. So if I click on help me choose, what things is coming up with Android Studio platform? If I click on KitKat, it shows me what new things came, hosting of NFC card emulator, reading SMS and MMS. So whatever the new things comes in the upcoming versions, it is already going to be showing you that what new things came in which version. So if I go and click on Nougat 24, API level 24, so it is going to show me what new things came. So if I click on Nougat 7.1, API level 25, it is going to show me that it's supports data server number blocking. Okay, so it has new things which is going to be coming in the new version. It is good platform for VR mode, so making a VR game or something, you need to have at least like Nougat 7.1, and all other version is not going to be very much compatible to VR. So if you are making VR, look forward to what update is there on which version, and accordingly you decide to that. Right, so we are making very simple. So Jelly Bean Nougat will be, so Jelly Bean API level 16 is very low and it shows 99.2. That means all the phones in the world is going to support this. So if I click on next, click on empty activity, click on next again and keep it as default and click on finish. So it is going to take some time, so I'll fast forward and continue when it has been built. Alright, so my application has been loaded and now I'm going to go and explore Gradle. So I'm going to open everything. So as you see it again and again, it is going to make yourself comfortable with all of the application and what are the folders inside the application. So this looks pretty nice to me because I like to make it much more clear in front of my eyes, so I never get messed up with what things is left. So I know each and everything what is going on in Android Studio if I keep everything on. So there you see import, so I'll keep it import as plus. So I see what are the imports in main activity.java, and this is the design view and this is the text view. Alright, so now I'm going to go and import some image, because create some application need to have some images to work with. It all depends, you start coding first or later you get the images, or you put the images first and with the images you start working on it. So this is how the application looks right now. There's, you can see there is no design to that. The reason behind that is in the styles. So if I click on styles and if I keep as dark action bar, and if I click like no action bar, so no action bar in the design, it is going to give no action to that, and there will be nothing on here. So maybe there must be chances that you must be seeing Ludo dice over there, but just because of the style and keeping as no action bar inside values folder, that is style, in the theme click no action bar, it is going to remove that dice one. Alright, so I'm going to go and look for to grab some images and pasting it inside the Android Studio. So I'm going to go and open up my folder. So this is my logo, so I'm going to go and put my logo to that, and I'm also going to copy one background to that and six of the dice images and the logo above the dice images. So final product of this images will be shown to you after some time. So but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 images of dice, one logo images, but that is going to come above the application, and one background image, and this is the application app logo. So right now I'm going to go and put an app logo to that. So to add a logo to that, what you have to do is click on new image asset, go and click on background. So inside desktop I have a Ludo, and inside the Ludo there is an image that is named as app logo. So this is app logo. If I click on OK, so it is going to go and appear. As you can see, it's covering up more of the logo. So I'm going to go and give it as trim. Yes, so let me go and keep it like more. So this looks nice to me. So I'm not little happy. So this looks nice to me. So it is going to go and add a logo like that to it. Maybe, okay. So this looks perfect. So I'm gonna go and click on next, finish. So this is going to go and put a logo to my application. Now I have to go and get all the images. So I'm gonna go and click on control and click all of the images. So I have clicked and control copy. Now I'm going to go inside my drawable folder, click on paste to that, because this is the easiest way to get all the images. So click on OK, and all the images inside my drawable folder. So that's about it for this video. I'll see you guys in the next one, where we actually do something with the application. Right now we just added some images to our application. So see you guys in the next one.